house. Everybody. Simmer down. I expect you all to take notes. There will be a lab on this next Friday, okay? So, the first thing I wanted to tell you were the ingredients that you'll need, because I want you to all perform this at home. I'll be assigning groups, and then you'll publish results to me. That's right. Okay. So today's topic is dehydroxynucleic acid, otherwise known as DNA. And we all know DNA is the building block of every organic living thing. Contains DNA. Okay, so today's lecture will be all about how to extract your own DNA. It is quite exciting, yes. Let me go over the list of things that you can please write down the ingredients on the board. Okay, thank you. You're going to need bottled water. Washing liquid or baby wash, and it has to be clear. Next, we'll be using 70% rubbing alcohol, and I chose this wintry color to eliminate steps like adding food coloring. There's no reason other than I wanted this color to show up. Finally, you'll need common everyday table salt. Going to be wearing gloves, mainly because I don't want to contaminate the sample, and I will be taking a sample from one of you. I have my gloves on. From the classroom, let's see, go ahead, put down your hands, Miss Smith, that's right, come on up, everything will be fine. Okay, I need to get a clear container. I chose this rather large container simply because I wanted the class to be able to see it. Since the auditorium is quite large. Okay, so I have two of these. Okay. Yes, I recommend it to be distilled bottled water, impurities in drinking water, and chemicals that we don't want, okay? Because it will totally contaminate our experiment. Yes, Professor. Are you sure you want me to be the tester? Okay. All right. Thank you. It seems like a lot. Sit down. Thank you. Okay, so here we go. Everybody give a round of applause for Ms. Smith. Thank you very much, dear. You can have a seat, you can see. This saline or salt water now contains the buccal. Class, but this, what are the buccal cells? Jimmy? Don't know, Paul? Correct. They are your cells from inside of your cheeks. Okay? So I'm gonna let that sit. Next, this is very, very crucial that you follow this step carefully. Just remove this. Okay, so from the clear soap, all I'm going to be using is one little container. And using this little stick, you're going to be picking up a drop the salt water solution. Now you're going to want to stir gently, and no bubbles, okay? Don't go crazy with the stirring, okay? So we do want to avoid bubbles at all costs. The salt water mixture solution. You in the back? Did you have a question? Well, soap breaks down the cell membranes. Inside each cell, you'll find a nucleus. Inside of that nucleus is DNA. We need to break open the cell membranes and the nuclear membrane. Both of these membranes contain lipids. Susie, what are lipids? Right, they're fats. Lipids are fats. And both cells contain linoleum, liquid soap, dish soap, baby soap, any kind of liquid soap that's designed to break up these fats. That's why your dishes come out clean. It's the same principle. So that's the reason for that. Okay, so the next thing we're doing is taking the alcohol and adding the jug of my notes. About 6.5 tablespoons to another glass container. This is just a clear mixture of alcohol. So the next thing is very crucial that you pour very slowly this alcohol into the DNA salt water mixture. Like this, almost as if you're pouring, soda or something with foam, and you don't want any suds. So, very slowly, I'm just dribbling. Rings and clumps solution. Thank you very much.